Magandang araw mga kapamilya. Today is Thursday, Memorial of Our Lady of Sorrows. Our Mass presider is Father Tito Caluag. Entrance Antiphone. Simeon said to Mary, "Behold, this child is destined for the ruin and rising of many in Israel, and to be a sign of contradiction, and your own soul a sword will pierce."
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. O God, who willed that when your Son was lifted high on the cross, his mother should stand close by and share his suffering, grant that your church, participating with the Virgin Mary in the Passion of Christ, may merit a share in his resurrection, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. I am reminding you, brothers and sisters, of the gospel I preached to you, which you indeed received and in which you also stand. Through it you are also being saved, if you hold fast to the word I preached to you, unless you believed in vain. For I handed on to you as of first importance what I also received, that Christ died for our sins in accordance with the Scriptures, that he was buried, that he was raised on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures, that he appeared to Cephas, then to the 12. After that, he appeared to more than 500 brothers at once, most of whom are still living, though some have fallen asleep. After that, he appeared to James, then to all the apostles. Last of all, as to one born abnormally, he appeared to me. For I am the least of the apostles, not fit to be called an apostle, because I persecuted the church of God. But by the grace of God, I am what I am, and his grace to me has not been ineffective. Indeed, I have toiled harder than all of them, not I, however, but the grace of God that is with me. Therefore, whether it be I or they, so we preach, and so you believed. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good.
Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good.
Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his mercy endures forever. Let the house of Israel say, his mercy endures forever.
Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good.
The right hand of the Lord is exalted. The right hand of the Lord has struck with power. I shall not die, but live, and declare the works of the Lord.
Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good.
You are my God, and I give thanks to you. O my God, I extol you.
Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good.
Alleluia, alleluia. Blessed are you, O Blessed Virgin Mary. Without dying, you won the martyr's crown beside the cross of the Lord. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
Standing by the cross of Jesus were his mother's sister, Mary White of Clopas, and Mary Magdalene. When Jesus saw his mother and the disciple whom he loved, he said to his mother, "Woman, behold your son." Then he said to the disciple, "Behold your mother." And from that hour onward, the disciple took her into his home. My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
You know, as we mentioned yesterday in our Mass, the Feast of the Exaltation of the Cross, I said we will reflect on Mary's own cross, no? And again, we need to remember that a lot of the spiritual writers would say that there is the fourth cross on Calvary was the cross of Mary. And when we look at that, yes, it was a share in the passion and suffering of her son. But I think a more deeper, or rather a deeper reflection on this is that it is a sharing in his mission, a very intimate and probably one of the most, you might say, personal sharing in the mission of Christ. And therefore, it is the prototype, the disciple that we look at with Mary standing at the foot of the cross as the fourth cross on Calvary. Siguro mahalagang makita natin na yung krus na mahal na birhen ay isang pagpapatunay ng kanyang napakalalim at personal na pakikibahagi sa misyon ng Panginoon. Sapagkat ang pakikibahagi natin sa misyon ng Panginoon ay pakikibahagi sa kanyang krus upang tayo ay makibahagi sa kanyang muling pagkabuhay. So today, let us reflect on three points on Mary's own cross. Number one is the cross of Mary began with commitment to mission. That first point, the commitment to mission. And then second is the constancy and the fidelity to mission. The constancy of living out the mission and the fidelity of living it out in the day-to-day. And then the third and last point is bringing that mission to completion. As we say, the prudence to bring to completion that mission. So there's three points on the cross of Mary. Siguro una sa lahat yung kanyang pagtatalaga ng sarili niya, yung pag-oo niya sa kagustuhan ng Panginoon, sa mission ng Panginoon para sa kanya. At yung pangalawang punto ay yung kanyang katapatan at yung kanyang katatagan na isabuhay itong mission na ito. At yung pangatlo naman ay yung patuloy na pangingilatis, yung patuloy na pagtitimbang, no? That prudence, that discerning attitude, no? Upang maisakatuparan yung kanyang mission. First, the commitment to mission. I think that all following of Christ or discipleship begins with our yes. As we've reflected in the past, you know, everything is an invitation from God, the invitation to follow Christ. And it is our yes that allows us to enter that relationship of being a disciple, being a follower of Christ. And very important is that yes, that commitment to share in the mission of Christ. And we saw our Blessed Mother give her yes, no, in the famous Fiat of Mary. "I am the handmaid of the Lord, let it be done to me according to your word." And with that, she became the mother of God, the mother of the Savior. Siguro ito yung unang mahalagang punto na dapat natin pagnilayan sa ating sariling buhay. Na kailangan tayo ay tumugon sa imbitasyon or sa tawag ng Diyos na tayo ay maging disipulo ng Panginoon. At kagaya ng Mahal na Birhen, ay sana maibigay natin ang ating oo sa paanyaya or sa tawag ng Diyos sa atin na makibahagi na sa misyon ng Panginoon sa ating mga sariling buhay. And then the second point is, you know, it is one thing to commit at the start, one thing to say yes, and it is another grace to be faithful to that yes and to constantly live out that yes, that fidelity and constancy. The fidelity to mission, the constancy in living out the mission in the day-to-day. And for this, in the life of the Blessed Mother, I think there are two very beautiful lines from Scripture. Number one is that we see very often in the Gospel of St. Luke, no? That when anything happened to her son, there's always that beautiful line, "And she kept all these things in her heart." And that was her fidelity and constancy. She kept all these things in her heart. She constantly discerned everything to understand more deeply and to see the movement of the Spirit. That is the gift of discernment. And then the other beautiful line is when, despite the rejection in the miracle at the wedding of Cana, the Blessed Mother tells everybody, do whatever He tells you. So these are two points, that scriptural points, that I invite you to reflect on with regard to the fidelity and constancy of our Blessed Mother to mission, to the following of her Son, to being the Mother of God and the Mother of the Savior. Siguro itong pangalawang punto na ito, no? Ano ba yung ating katapatan sa pagsunod natin sa Panginoon sa araw-araw? At yung ating pagiging tapat at matatag, no? Yung ating pagiging matatag at magiging consistent, no? Constant sa ating pagsunod sa Panginoon. Siguro yan ay napakahalaga, kasi yan ang nagbibigay o nagpapalalim ng ating pagiging alagad o tagasunod ng Panginoon. Kagaya nga makikita natin sa buhay ng mahal na Birhen, pag meron siyang hindi nauunawaan, lagi niyang pinagninilayan sa kanyang puso. Makikita natin yan sa banal na kasalutan. At ito ay pagnilayan at pinagninilayan niya sa kanyang puso. At yung pangalawa nga, na bagaman hindi siya pinagbigyan ng anak niya, tandaan niyo yung yung miracle, yung milagro na ginawang alak yung tubig. Una, sabi ng Panginoon, hindi pa pwede, no? Pero nung sabi ng mahal na Birhen, gawin niyo kung ano man ang sabihin niya. Dito natin makikita ang katapatan ng mahal na Birhen sa kanyang misyon. Then the third and final point is the prudence to bring it to completion. That constant discerning, that constant following of the movement of the Spirit of God to bring our mission to completion. And precisely, it is that prudence of the Blessed Mother, it is her constant following of the Spirit of God that leads her now at the foot of the cross in today's gospel. This is the fulfillment of the mission. Yes, a share in the cross and suffering of her Son. But remember, on Calvary, on the cross, with Mary at the foot of the cross, her Son begins now to achieve His mission. It is on the cross and in the resurrection that Christ truly becomes the Son of God and truly becomes now our Redeemer, the Mother of God and the Mother of the Redeemer. And here we see this in the central mystery of our faith, the cross and resurrection. And the Blessed Mother shares in this mystery, standing at the foot of the cross, being the fourth cross on Calvary. Siguro ito yung huli at napakahalagang punto, na ang pagsasakatuparan ng misyon ng Panginoon ay nasa krus at muling pagkabuhay. At nariyan ang mahal na Birhen. Nariyan siya sa nakatayo, ano? Nakatayo sa krus, sa tabi ng krus ng Panginoon. Siya nga ang pang-apat na krus sa Kalbaryo. And today, as we celebrate her feast, we ask our Blessed Mother to be like her, to be at the foot of the cross, to be placed with the Son under the standard of the cross, which we celebrated yesterday, and sharing very deeply in His mission to heal and make whole a wounded and broken world. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Together with Mary, who knows what it means to suffer, let us pray to God for those who have heavy crosses to bear as we say, Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who are heavily burdened by sorrow and trials may find peace and comfort as they reflect on the sorrows of Mary, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may accept the sorrows and sufferings of life and discern God's presence in them, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That through the example of Mary, we may be patient in suffering and persevering in doing good works, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. And let us now offer the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. For all this we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And let us now offer our prayer for our nation.
Panginoon ng kasaysayan, sa simula ng aming paghahanda para sa 125th anibersaryo ng pagsilang ng aming bansa, sabayan mo po kami sa aming paglalakbay tungo sa pagiging isang lipunang may tunay na kalayaan para sa lahat. Kalayaang nakaugat sa pagkalinga, hustisya at katotohanan. Kalayaan mula sa kahirapan na nag-aalis mula sa nakararami ng pagkakataong mapabuti ang kanilang buhay. Kalayaan mula sa gutom, kawalan ng tirahan at kakulangan ng dekalidad ng mga simpleng serbisyo sa pangangalaga ng kalusugan at sa edukasyon. Kalayaan mula sa panilinlang, kasinungalingan at manipulasyon. Kalayaan upang maging mga aktibo at positibong tagapagbuo ng aming bansa. Bigyan mo kami ng katatagan ng loob at inspirasyon na walang humpay na itaguyod ang isang bansang tunay na malaya para sa lahat ng mga Pilipino. Amen.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this, our sacrifice, may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
Receive, O merciful God, to the praise of your name, the prayers and sacrificial offerings, which we bring to you as we venerate the Blessed Virgin Mary, whom you graciously gave us as a most devoted mother when she stood by the cross of Jesus, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, and to praise, bless, and glorify your name on the feast day of the Blessed Virgin Mary, Our Lady of Sorrows. For by the overshadowing of the Holy Spirit, you conceive your only begotten Son, and without losing the glory of virginity, brought forth into the world the eternal light, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Through him and through the angels we praise your majesty. Dominions adore and powers tremble before you. Heaven and the virtues of heaven and the blessed seraphim worship together with exaltation. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in humble praise as we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
the mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Accept, Father Most Holy, all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, and protect us from all anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace, the unity, and the joy of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. An act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me be separated from you. Amen.
And let us spend a few moments of silence. And together now, let us offer our prayer for an end to the pandemic and to rebuild our nation.
Merciful and compassionate Father, we humbly come to you to find forgiveness in life. We come to ask for your grace and guidance as we emerge from this pandemic. Bless all those who help see us through the challenges the pandemic brought, those who tirelessly work to render genuine service, especially to those who suffered the most. Guide the people tasked to find cures for this disease and to stem its transmission and to end this pandemic. Heal all who are afflicted. Grant eternal rest to those who have died and consolation to their loved ones. As we move forward, grant us the grace to see clearly, choose well and act right, in order to build a nation closer to your kingdom of justice, truth, equality, faith, hope, compassion, and love. Grant all this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not deny our petition, but deliver us always from all dangers, O glorious and blessed Virgin.
Amen.
Our Lady, help of all Christians and health of the sick.
Pray for us.
Our Lady of Fatima.
Pray for us.
Saint Joseph.
Pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel.
Pray for us.
Saint Roch.
Pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz.
Pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsod.
Pray for us.
Most Sacred Heart of Jesus.
Have mercy on us.
Santo Niño de Cebu.
Have mercy on us.
Divine Mercy.
Have mercy on us. And let us pray. Having received the sacrament of eternal redemption, we humbly ask, O Lord, that honoring how the Blessed Virgin Mary suffered with her Son, we may complete in ourselves, for the Church's sake, what is lacking in the sufferings of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
And let us now offer our prayer for peace and for joy and joy for our world. Father in heaven, to you we offer this prayer in the words of our Holy Father, Pope Francis. We have so much more to do and we must do it together. In the darkness of the conflicts we are living through, each of us can become a bright candle to remind us that light will overcome darkness and never the other way around. To us Christians, the future has a name and its name is hope. It is the virtue of the heart that does not lock itself up, does not dwell on the past, and not only survives the present, but is able to see tomorrow. Bless our world, Father, with the peace and joy the cross and resurrection of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, won for us. For all those affected by calamities natural and man-made, for all those who suffer from the structural injustices of our time, amen. Our Lady, Mother of God and Mother of the Church,
pray for us.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless us, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.
Marami pong salamat and have a good day ahead. Thank you.
Pagmamalasakit, pagbabahagi at pag-alay kapwa, may napakain tayong 1,757 individuals na nanggagaling sa 300 families from Luzon, Visayas at Mindanao. Ang pamilya program ay hindi lang po natin bubusugin ang tiyan ng ating mga tinutulungan, mga pamilya, kung hindi bubusugin din natin ang kanilang isip at puso. Dahil sa pamilya feeding program, ang mga kapamilya na tinutulungan natin ay lumalalim ang kanilang pananampalataya, pakipag-ugnayan sa kapwa at pagmamalasakit sa lipunan. Nang dahil sa inyo, ang mga kapwa natin ay nabusog, nabigyan ng pag-asa at may maliwanag na bukas. Through pamilya program, stomachs are fed, hearts are full, souls are nourished. Taus-puso kaming nagpapasalamat sa lahat ng mga kapamilya natin na nagmalasakit, nagbahagi, at nag-alay kapwa.